Hello, and welcome to Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Jenny. And Jenny asks, do you use an isotype control with your FMO control? Now, Jenny, that's a great question because it gets to a practice that some people do where they combine the isotype control and FMO control in an effort to use both to set gates. Now, the FMO control is used to set gates based on the spectral spillover into your channel of interest, that spectral spreading. And we want to make sure that we set the gate properly using the FMO control. The isotype control adds nothing to this. In fact, the isotype control is probably not a useful control to use at all, except to tell you that you've had poor blocking. If we think about it for a minute, the isotype control is designed to be a reagent that is will address the nonspecific binding of our isotype of interest. If we look at a classic isotype control, that is the clone MOPC21, which is a mouse IgG1 kappa clone. This has been published since the 1970s, and nobody knows what it actually binds to. So one of the first questions you ask yourself is, if we don't know what it binds to, how do we know that that is not on our cells of interest? Yes, vendors have tested it, and it's been tested in various cells and cell lines, but that doesn't necessarily address the specific question, is that binding to our specific cell type? Second, we don't know what that off-target binding is, and if it's even similar to our antibody of interest. Finally, we don't necessarily know the F-to-P ratio. So rather than use an isotype control, save your money, focus on the FMO control, focus on, during panel development, identifying internal negative controls to help define your populations of interest. Further refine your panels using unstimulated and stimulated controls, and include a reference control so that you know your panel is working correctly. So with that, I'd like to thank you for your question, Jenny. And remember, if you have more questions, go to getflowtraining.com and you can learn more about the Expert Cytometry program. If you have questions that you want answered, send them to me here at askexcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another Ask Excite. Until next time, be sure to keep up with your best practices in flow cytometry right here with Tim and Team Excite.